This friend, he says the human condition, the human nature, being human, is to be cold and alone, like someone lost in the woods. It's safe to say he's a glasses half empty kind of guy. And I see nature differently. I see the ancient machinery of the world, elegant and ferocious, neither good nor bad. It's full of beautiful things, unspeakable things. The trick is to keep them hidden until the right moment.
You know, we were talking about you. Me and two of the girls from radiology. You intrigue us. You don't use lines. You talk about ancient machinery. You do conjuring tricks. Your eyes are sad, even when you laugh. And when you look at me, it's heavy. It's old. Nira says, I'm gonna shut up now.
What? What did she say?
No. She thinks you're dangerous.
She said that. She used that word.
I thought it was odd too. Are you dangerous, Mitchell?
I should go.
Oh, sorry. Hello?
Oh, hi. Yeah. Just a headache.
No, it's coming more so than you hearing you.
Nice blouse. Where did you leave your clothes?
I don't know. I don't know where we are. I had to get the operator to tell me where I was calling from. Thank you.
You okay? You look weird.
Well, this from a man in collapse. You've got blood on your face.
It's okay. It's only a daze.
Come on, Lassie. We'll swing by your hostel, get you some clothes. Does it still hurt?
Curses are meant to hurt.
And all.
Worked in A&E.
Of course, they're all in pieces.
Friend of yours?
No. Kind of.
Flatmate found a heart attack, the coroner says. Doesn't seem right, does it? Pretty thing like that. Whole life ahead of her. Richard Littlejohn still walking around.
Hiya. We're here for the pickup. Lauren Drake. This her?
I'll get the papers.
All right, Mitchell.
Sir.
When I got the call, I was a little surprised. I said to Edgar, when was the last time Mitchell recruited? But, mate, these incisions, they're like pinpricks. Was this deliberate? They're in a cluster of freckles or something. I can hardly see them. Seriously, I'm impressed. What did the coroner say?
Heart attack.
He's a good boy. Herrick's back. Asked me to express his thanks.
Herrick? Since when was it up to him to say thanks?
Just thought he should, that's all.
It's good to have you back, Mitchell.
It's been a long time since you brought someone to the party. People were beginning to talk.
When she drank.
What?
When she drank. It might have been too late.
She was still alive, wasn't she?
Yeah. Just, I don't know. It might not have worked.
So this is a disposal job now, is that what you're saying?
Saying? I don't know.
This is an afterthought then, yeah? Hey, Mitchell! Mitchell! How's your pet?
Are you sure it was your ex-girlfriend?
The name? The epilepsy? Who else could it be? Besides, I just know it's her.
So, what are you gonna do?
Change my shifts, I guess. It's only for a couple of days. I mean, I can't see her.
Why not?
She thinks I'm dead. Well, she thinks I'm... But I don't know what she thinks. I haven't seen her for 2 years.
You've got to talk to her.
Does she want to know why I disappeared?
Yeah, there's a pretty good chance that'll come up.
So what do I say?
This had to happen sooner or later. Well, not this, but something like this.
What do you mean?
You can't keep hiding, George.
It's only for a couple of days.
I don't just mean from her.
Did you hear about Lauren in A&E? Heart attack. Can you believe it?
Did you know that?
A little. She was an only child. Did you know that? Her parents must be. I mean, I can't imagine.
So I was thinking maybe we could get somewhere to live.
What, together? Are you serious?
I was thinking I might go on the wagon for a bit.
What, you mean their blood? Can you do that?
I can try. And this would help. The more structure I've got, the more routine and normality, the easier it is.
Why now?
I don't know. When in Rome, stop killing the other Romans.
You talk about normality like it's some kind of... like it's fair. The same rules do not apply to us.
What's the worst that could happen?
I could lose it all again.
This is the curse, George. Not what happens to you every full moon. This.
George?
Julia.
Jesus Christ. George.
Sorry, I didn't want to wake you.
We thought you died.
I know. Sorry.
What happened to you?
I should go.
Go, you can't go.
This was a bad idea.
I thought you died. We grieved for you, and now you turn up here. Why, are you a doctor or something?
I'm a porter.
A porter? Christ, George. You've got an IQ of 156 and you're a bloody hospital porter. Your mum would go mental.
I caught something.
Like a disease?
Are you seeing anyone?
I'm engaged. How could you just leave us all, George? How could you leave me?
We wouldn't. If it hadn't been this, it would have been something.
What do you mean?
People like you don't stay with people like me. I was just the filling guy. I'm the guy you look back on and say, oh, he was sweet. If it hadn't been this, it would have been something.
But I adored you. You caught something, is it? Christ, I don't know what to think. What is it?
It's something old.
Are you staying here? Is this where you are now? Only, I've got to come back in a few weeks. I've got this outpatient thing. So I've got to come back. So if you were still here, then maybe I'd see you.
I'd like that.
I'd like that too.
They said some stuff about you to Lauren. Just stupid stuff. But it feels important now to say I'm sorry.
You said I was dangerous.
If she was, crap at keeping secrets. It was out of order. I don't know you.
So, a house or a flat?
Whatever we can afford.
And if we need to move on again?
We move on.
We share the cleaning.
We can drop a rotor. I'll buy highlighter pens and everything.
What about guests?
We can't ask them to clean.
Oh. What if one of us wants to have a guest?
In your last house, you clearly had a level of security I am not used to. If you want a guest, you have a guest. Wait a sec, are you talking about lady-shaped guests?
No. I don't know.
George, don't make me come over there. Oh, my God, you've talked to her, haven't you? What did she say? How is she?
She's beautiful.
You have. OK.
I'll get on to it. But I am not having you turn my nice house into the Playboy Mansion.
And we want a proper sofa so we can sit in front of the TV with a beer and a pizza.
Well, what about a futon?
I hate futons. People get spinal injuries from futons. If it's a futon, I am walking out.
It was owned by a sculptor. It was his studio. Then a young couple bought it. The plan was to refurbish, but the girl died before they could get much done. Hence its individual decor.
Well, that's one way of putting it. I don't know. See, my friend, he's very picky. He took a lot of convincing to agree to this.
You can actually see the top of the hospital from the window. And it's a dinky little kitchen. We could fit a table in there, maybe. Otherwise, if we have people over, we can just sit in here. And the little garden is just gorgeous. We could grow vegetables.
Like I said, he's a very difficult customer. Why has it been on the market so long? The rent's pretty reasonable.
The back of the house doesn't get much sunlight.
I'm not mad about sunlight.
And as you can see, the house presents certain challenges.
Yeah, but the university's only 10 minutes away. You must be able to get some students in.
OK, look, there have been a few people, but it hasn't worked out. Personally, I just don't think they thought it through, but legally, I'm obliged to tell you that they thought it was creepy.
Creepy?
They said they could detect something. I mean, it's ridiculous, obviously. I mean, can you detect anything creepy?
We're probably not the best people to ask.
I'm loving the kitchen. It's like a catalogue. Look, your sofa! He has this thing about me and him on a sofa.
It's fine. We've catered for people in your situation before.
I doubt that.
No, really, we found a lovely flat for two ladies in Cottam. Well, I wasn't sure at first, but then one of them said she was in the TA, and... Well, you do the math.
What are you laughing at?
No, don't get me wrong. They were nice and everything. It's just... I don't understand all that. I'm like you. I like Dick too much.
You're just like him. I swear it's relentless.
No, hang on. We're not gay.
He hasn't told his parents yet.
I had a girlfriend.
But he realised he was living a lie.
So, what's it going to be, fellas? Shall I ring the landlord?
What the hell?
Nice one. I'll call from the car.
How could she think we were a couple?
Yeah. I am way out of your league.
Where is she going to do this? I can't believe it.
But just so you know, people have said they think it's creepy here.
Bloody will be now.
Let me carry you over the threshold.
What?
Come on. It's a big day.
Don't be ridiculous.
It's mean a lot to me, George.
Ha ha.